SpaceX's achievements are raising concerns among competitors, while NASA proudly applauds their success. Yes, you heard it right. Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started. You know, the entire space industry has witnessed tremendous developments over the past few years, but nothing quite compares to the revolution SpaceX has brought. Do you agree with me? We all know that SpaceX is on a relentless march toward achieving rapid reusability for space travel, a feat once thought impossible. Their bold ambitions were again highlighted during the latest test flight of its Starship Super Heavy vehicle on October 13, 2024, at its facility in Boca Chica, Texas. This significant milestone came just a day before the opening of the International Astronautical Congress, IAC, held in Baku, Azerbaijan. For many of the more than 11,000 participants at the IAC, this event outshone much of the formal conference proceedings, as it showcased SpaceX's formidable capabilities in a way that no other company could match. The recent flight demonstrated the successful return of the Super Heavy booster to its launch site and its capture by mechanical arms attached to the launch tower, a crucial step toward achieving SpaceX's goal of making space travel as routine and reusable as air travel. This success has not only strengthened SpaceX's partnership with NASA, particularly in the context of the Human Landing System, HLS program for the Artemis missions, but it has also raised important questions about the future of spaceflight and the competitive dynamics within the global space industry. Starship is central to SpaceX's plans for deep space missions, including the return of humans to the moon and, ultimately, the first crewed missions to Mars. NASA selected SpaceX's Starship as the landing system for its Artemis program, which aims to land the next astronauts on the lunar surface by late 2026. The Artemis 3 mission, scheduled for no earlier than September 2026, will use the HLS version of Starship to ferry astronauts from lunar orbit to the surface of the moon. The October 13th flight test marked a significant step toward that goal, demonstrating the booster's ability to return to the launch site, a critical feature for rapid reusability. This catch maneuver is essential to SpaceX's vision of a fully reusable launch system, where both the Starship vehicle and its booster can be turned around quickly for subsequent launches. NASA Administrator Bill Nelson, speaking at IAC the day after the flight, hailed it as a significant achievement that confirmed SpaceX was on track to meet the milestones for the HLS program. Just yesterday, SpaceX had a very successful fifth launch as they developed this very large rocket, Nelson said during a plenary session. He went on to highlight that the test was right on the mark, moving SpaceX closer to achieving the capability necessary for the Artemis 3 landing. NASA has placed immense trust in SpaceX to deliver on these objectives, and the latest test offers further confidence in their collaboration. The partnership between NASA and SpaceX has revolutionized space exploration and launch services, particularly in the context of the Artemis program. NASA's initial reliance on traditional aerospace giants like Boeing and Lockheed Martin through their joint venture, United Launch Alliance, ULA, and Boeing's Space Launch System, SLS, has been a mixed bag at best. The SLS, often criticized for its staggering cost and delayed schedule, is a prime example of legacy systems burdened by bureaucracy and inefficiency. The contrast with SpaceX's leaner, faster, and more innovative approach could not be starker. SpaceX has repeatedly demonstrated that it can deliver groundbreaking results at a fraction of the cost of traditional aerospace companies. The Falcon 9, for instance, revolutionized launch economics by introducing reusable rockets, a development that SpaceX has since perfected. NASA has reaped the benefits of this efficiency, significantly lowering its launch costs and enabling more ambitious programs such as Artemis. In the past, NASA was heavily reliant on ULA's Atlas V and Delta IV rockets for launching missions. While these rockets have a strong track record, they are expensive and expendable, leading to higher costs for taxpayers. SLS, meanwhile, was conceived as the successor to the space shuttle and designed to enable human space exploration beyond low Earth orbit. However, the program has been plagued by years of delays and budget overruns. With an estimated cost per launch exceeding $4 billion, the SLS has been a lightning rod for criticism. In comparison, SpaceX's Starship is not only expected to be more capable in terms of payload capacity and flexibility, but also drastically cheaper thanks to its fully reusable design. The NASA-SpaceX collaboration is a textbook example of how public-private partnerships can deliver innovation and value. By outsourcing critical parts of its lunar missions to SpaceX, NASA has freed itself from the constraints of managing an entirely government-run program, allowing it to focus on mission planning, scientific objectives, and exploration goals. Starship's recent test flight reinforced this vision, with many at IAC recognizing the implications of such capabilities. Commercial space station operators, satellite companies, and lunar missions all stand to benefit from the frequent and cost-effective access to space that Starship promises. It could open up new opportunities for commercial ventures, from in-orbit manufacturing to lunar mining. While the US space industry has made significant strides thanks to SpaceX, the same cannot be said for many of its international competitors. The latest Starship flight has caused concern in Europe, where the launch industry is undergoing a crisis. The continent has struggled to keep pace with the rapid developments in reusable launch technology, even as the Ariane 6 launcher, Europe's flagship heavy-lift rocket, prepares for its first operational flight after significant delays. For many European space companies, the success of Starship underscored the growing gap between SpaceX and the rest of the world. Rocket Factory Augsburg, a German small launch vehicle manufacturer, congratulated SpaceX on its achievements in a social media post, but lamented Europe's failure to keep up. At the same time, the coin has a second side. It shows and confirms that Europe has completely lost touch. Can it still catch up? No chance, the company wrote. Josef Aschbacher, the Director General of the European Space Agency, ESA, echoed some of these concerns. Speaking during an interview at IAC, Aschbacher acknowledged that Europe cannot compete head-to-head with SpaceX in terms of launch capability. Instead, he suggested that Europe should look to carve out a niche within the evolving space economy, perhaps focusing on specific segments such as satellite manufacturing, in-space services, or space exploration technologies. You can imagine that if Starship brings 100 tons into space frequently, this will change everything out there in space, he said, alluding to the disruptive potential of Starship. The latest Starship test flight has driven home a simple but profound truth. Reusability is the future of spaceflight. SpaceX has proven that recovering and reusing launch systems can significantly reduce costs, increase launch frequency, and open up new possibilities for space exploration and commercial ventures. This reality has forced other spacefaring nations and companies to rethink their approach to launch vehicle development. India, another emerging space power, is also taking notice. S. Somanath, chairman of the Indian Space Research Organization, ISRO, mentioned during IAC that India had approved the development of a new reusable rocket, the Next Generation Launch Vehicle, NGLV. This rocket will provide increased payload capacity and feature a reusable booster similar to SpaceX's Falcon 9. Somanath estimated that the NGLV would take about 6 years to develop, reflecting the global consensus that reusable rockets are essential for the future of space exploration. So, SpaceX's successful Starship test is a major leap forward, not only for the company, but also for the broader space industry. Its partnership with NASA has redefined the way we think about space exploration, bringing down costs and pushing the boundaries of what is possible. While NASA has benefited immensely from SpaceX's innovations, the rest of the space industry is left playing catch-up. Europe, in particular, finds itself at a crossroads, forced to reconsider its role in a rapidly changing space economy. The future of human spaceflight, and indeed the future of the space industry as a whole, will be shaped by the companies and nations that can adapt to this new era of reusable, cost-effective space access. SpaceX, with its eye on Mars, is leading the way, and others must innovate or risk being left behind. Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.